Welcome to this week's edition of When Can We Do This Again? Your tips, tricks, reviews, previews, all things good, maybe not so good when it comes to Walt Disney World. This is where you can find your hacks and tips, things that will help you spend less money, enjoy more time in the parks, just get so much more out of your Walt Disney World vacation. If this is your first time, hit the channel, hit that subscribe button, and let's get started. This week on When Can We Do This Again, we are going to talk about spring break, as I have the Braves jersey going, as spring training kicks up in Florida, and spring is in the air. There's a song or something. I probably don't know it, but it's spring break season, and that means another busy season at Walt Disney World. If you know the seasons and things, I made a video a few weeks back talking about when to go and what not to go and where to go and all that stuff. It's right up here. And it talks about spring break being one of the busiest seasons. If you know when to plan your trip, or you plan your trip certain times of the year every year, and you want to give some people advice on when or what time of the year is the best for you, boom, hit it down there in the comments and let me know when you plan your trip to Walt Disney World and how you get the most out of that trip. Now, let's talk about spring break around Walt Disney World. Spring break is one of the busiest times of the year at Walt Disney World, and you're gonna wanna get your max, your most out of spring break. And here's five quick tips. I'm gonna do this one really quick. I'm gonna get to the point and go on and help you with your vacation. The first thing I'm gonna mention, guess what? That is the FastPass system. Make the most out of your FastPass. Some people go to Walt Disney World and don't even realize the FastPass system exists, or they think you have to pay for it. But guess what, you get three. You get three every day right off the bat, and then once you use those three, you can go on and use more. So you have all the fast passes in the world if you use them the right way. Now, there's different thoughts and theories on how to do this. Some people say you should book them the first three out in the morning, like 9, 10, 11. Use them and go ahead and use your other one rotatingly throughout the day, because once you walk into the line on the last one and scan that magic band, guess what? You can start booking your next fast pass. That is definitely one theory, and a very good theory, and a very good way to do it. As well, you could also save these till the afternoon, go ride rides all morning because it's the slowest in the morning, and then when the afternoon hits, you have your fast passes and they're available to you. The second thing I'm gonna advise here on spring break is it is hot and it's humid in Florida. So here are two really quick ways to avoid humidity and stay good. One, drink water. Drink plenty of water while at Walt Disney World. This is gonna help you stay hydrated and enjoy your trip so much more. You don't know how many days that I've got dehydrated without even realizing it and felt awful by the end of the day. The second one of these tips is enjoy the shows in the mid-afternoon. These shows are air conditioned. Whether you're headed to, let's see, any of the shows in the theaters at Epcot, whether you're headed to Festival of the Lion King, whether you're headed to Frozen Ever After Show over in Hollywood, or any of the theater type shows at Magic Kingdom, go to these shows in mid-afternoon, stay out of that heat a little bit, and enjoy your time a whole heck of a lot more. Another way to enjoy your time during spring break, and this is kind of the obvious, I would think, but it might not be even with a park day. It might be going out to the pool and just hanging out at the pool, chilling, having a down day. Because you know what? From what I hear, there's no lines at the pool. You don't have to stand in line all day to get into the pool. You can just go jump on in. So go to the pools. There's plenty. If you're staying at a Walt Disney World resort, there's one at every one. And there are definitely some great pools in these resorts. Definitely take some time, take a down day, enjoy yourself, chill a little bit, hop in the pool. Another quick way to enjoy your trip during spring break and get the most out of it is know about extra magic hours. If you're staying on property, you get those extra magic hours that time of the day. Guess what? So much less packed, guys. Go enjoy those extra magic hours, especially if you have a park hopper and you can get out of that park as soon as those hours are over. That is going to be another way that you can maximize your spring break trip. Last but not least, and this tip might seem so obvious, and this might be something that you're going to do anyway, but it's have fun. Have fun, guys. You're at Walt Disney World. Yes, it's spring break and it's crowded, but guess what? A bad day in Walt Disney World is so much better than a good day at most places. Would you rather have a good day at work or a bad day at Walt Disney World? I will take the bad day at Walt Disney World any time of the year, and guess what? I don't have very many bad days at Walt Disney World, so just go, have fun, don't stress, enjoy yourself, and just enjoy it. Just set back, chill, relax, maybe take in the parks, maybe people watch a little bit. Just enjoy yourself while you're on your vacation to Walt Disney World. Spring break is a busy time, but it's all about you, how you view it, and how your mindset's gonna be when it comes to enjoying yourself at Walt Disney World. Well, everybody, that is it for today. If you have any tips or tricks that I didn't miss, like I said, this was just kind of a quick tip video. So I'm sure there's plenty of things out there that you can comment down below on ways to enjoy your spring break so much more at Walt Disney World than just going and showing up and not knowing what to do. If you have any of those comments, hit them down below in the comments. If this is your first time on the channel, there's a subscribe button. There's a subscribe button right there, guys. And like I said, if you like this video, like it, hit that like button. Guys, I'm gonna get out of here. I hope you've enjoyed this week's edition of When Can We Do This Again. I hope you enjoy your upcoming spring break trip, and I hope this helps you get so much more out of your spring break trip at Walt Disney World. Until next time, guys, I hope to see you again so we can do this again.